Bank rules in QuickBooks Online can help you so much. It can help streamline your bookkeeping process. It can help you create consistency in your bookkeeping so that every time a transaction comes in, it always goes to a certain category. It can also help you as a business owner think through what are the recurring transactions in your business and help your bookkeeper by, you know, making their job a lot easier and hopefully making your monthly fee to them much lower. So let's talk today about how to create rules in QuickBooks Online. So that is what this video is about. We're gonna hop directly into the QuickBooks sample company that we've been working in during this series, how to do stuff in QuickBooks Online. And we're going to get in and show you how to set up rules and different things you can think about. And you know, QuickBooks Online actually has a lot of tools and different ways that you can sort the data to tell it what you want it to do. So this is like creating an automation. So we have automations in our email. We have automations for all different types of software. We have automations in our email newsletter list, for example. But when it comes to accounting, there's also lots of opportunity to automate. It's super helpful to you. Now, I don't recommend completely outsourcing all of your accounting to a robot. I don't think that's the way to go, but we can train the system to start recognizing things, and we can set up rules that will help us have consistency in the data coming in and the categorization of that data. So I always think it's a good thing to put a human eye on our bookkeeping and use somebody who has context to the business to help you with your bookkeeping. But these rules can be a huge time saver. So that's what we're going to work on today. So if this type of information is helpful to you, please make sure you go ahead and subscribe to the channel, and please also like this video and let us know if there's anything else you'd like to learn in QuickBooks Online, because that's what we're doing. We're doing in this series. We're learning things about QuickBooks Online, okay? And even if you missed the series and you're watching this months and months later, still tell me what you'd like to see and what you'd like to learn in QuickBooks Online, because it's the platform that we use for most of our small businesses that we serve. And it's actually our favorite small business accounting software. So please be sure to keep those questions flowing, regardless of when you watch this video. And let's just go ahead and get into it. So here we go into QuickBooks Online. Okay, so here we are in the sample company. And in this situation, we are looking at this in the accountant's view. And I am showing you guys how to record different rules and create different rules to help streamline your bookkeeping. So what we're going to do is look at this, and the easiest way to start adding rules is to by clicking on a transaction. And I'm actually going to start with an uncategorized expense, because in this situation, you see all these matches. A lot of these transactions are already have something in the system. And I want to focus first on the things that don't have a categorized, or they don't have something that the system has already recognize. So I'm going to start with this A rental here. And so just because, let's say I have some knowledge of this client and I understand that A1 rental is actually an equipment rental for this type of business. And then when I look here at the bank detail, it tells me if this was for a backhoe rental. Okay. Normally you wouldn't have probably that much detail in the bank detail, but it would tell you the vendor and maybe like a date or something here. We know that this is for equipment rentals because we've talked to this business owner and we know what this is. So we can go ahead down here and say create a rule. And we know that A1 rental is someplace that they go to on a regular basis. So when you're setting up rules, you really want to think about anything that could be recurring, just, you know, whether you're on like a monthly recurring expense, or potentially if you use a vendor consistently, even if it's not in a regular cycle, but you, let's, in this example, A1 rental is a place that this business owner goes on a regular basis. So in that situation, we could set up a rule, which would be really helpful. Or if you have something that's an amount that is really consistent. So let's say you sell a digital product and every time it comes in, it's $19. That might be a really great way to also categorize things if you have a really consistent amount. So amounts are a little bit harder to make sure that those always go to the right place, because you could happen to sell something or you could happen to buy something and it ends up being exactly $19 in that situation. So you want to be a little bit careful on, you know, creating rules on dollar amounts alone, but it can be done. All right. So what we're going to call this one, this is kind of the quick create rule. And when we click on it from a transaction, if QuickBooks is smart enough to go ahead and pre-populate some of this stuff. So in this situation, it says, this was money going out of the checking account, but you can change this to all bank accounts. So that's maybe if sometimes you use maybe a debit card or sometimes you use a credit card, you can put it to all accounts, which makes things a little bit easier. You're going to go ahead and name it. I'm just going to put A1 Rental Company. And then what else can we do here? We can set up, do we want the description to contain something? I actually, because the bank text was more descriptive, I'm going to go to bank text and say A1 rental because I saw that on there. And I think that's all I want because I don't want to limit it by amounts because sometimes we rent things for different prices and I think that's just fine. So we'll just keep it to bank text contains A1 rental. Okay, and then we're going to go ahead and assign, and that's the option we're going to choose most of the time. And it's going to be expense. And then this is where we say what type of transaction was it. You can do these different types, so transfers, checks, credit card payments. Usually we're going to be setting up rules for either certain income or certain expenses, so we're going to select that. If I were to change this and it was money in, it would change my transaction types. So that's just something to keep in mind. Money out. And then we're going to give it a category and we're going to say, what was this? What is A1 Rentals? So I'm going to go ahead and see if they have, and they do, equipment rentals account. And then we're going to go ahead and select the payee. We always want to have a payee, and looky there, there is A1 Rental. So every time a transaction comes through on the bank feeds, the system is going to kind of run it through the paces. And if it meets all of these rules, it will code it to this category and it will put this payee into the payee line. And this is also where we have the option to say, do we want to auto add it, which means it kind of skips over this bank feed and the review process altogether, or do we want to keep it off of auto add? I think when you're first setting up bank rolls, I highly recommend taking it off of auto add just because when you're first setting up bank rules, you want to make sure that you're doing it correctly. And you might, I've had some times where sometimes people set up rules, but they might have not thought about a condition that they should have maybe excluded or included, and then they'll auto add all of these things to the wrong category. So I would recommend turning off auto add to start, and then after you see that the rule is working and it's working with your transactions, then you could come in, edit the rule, and turn it on if you want to do that. You know, it's also when something, see how now this has a rule here and it's already kind of told us what the system thinks it is. So now job expenses, equipment, and equipment over here, equipment rental there. So in that situation, it makes it very easy to just click add. And the review process is extremely easy and this is so much faster. So you don't have to click in here, select the category or anything like that because it's already done for you. So in that situation, you know, it doesn't really hurt to keep it off of auto add because it just makes it very simple to click add. And then you do get that sense of like being able to review things and make sure that it's still correct because sometimes a rule might pick up the wrong thing. So you don't want to do that. All right, so in this situation, the reason that this one, although this one also says a rental, this one didn't get picked up because the rule was only for money going out. So if we want to have a separate rule for money coming back to us, we would go ahead and set up another rule. So for this one, this might be a deposit refund or something. We have to name it something different. But in this situation, it would be money in. Let's go ahead and do all bank accounts. We're going to go to the bank text again, change that to A1 rental because we saw that in the bank text. It's a deposit. We're going to go to equipment rental because they got maybe that money back from returning everything on time. And then we're going to also do A1. So essentially this would net out. The money goes out on one day and then comes back to the same line item on the second day.
when they returned the equipment, so it would sort of net to the right amount. And then we're going to do the same thing and keep the auto add off and click save. All right, so see, now we have these rules and we can go add, add, add. Easy peasy. Okay, the second way that you can add rules is you can do them up here. So these are the two rules we just created. I'm going to set up a couple other rules that I see on a regular basis that can be tricky to people sometimes. So one that I see that, you know, kind of plagues me in my own business is my charges to Microsoft. So I'm going to go ahead and Microsoft. There we go. Maybe Microsoft 365. I'm going to put that in there because I get charged for Microsoft 365, but I have multiple accounts and they're kind of on different billing cycles. So in this situation, I want to set this up and I'm just kind of giving you guys an example at this point. This is always going to be money out. I'm going to do all bank accounts as the default. And this is where, let's see, I want to include all of the following. I want the bank text. So when Microsoft actually charges my card, the bank text is tons of like gibberish, basically, text gibberish, but it does always contain the word Microsoft. But every single transaction comes in with different gibberish and different numbers on there. So I can't just say that the bank text always matches exactly a certain amount. But so I can use this contains filter. And I can also do it exactly, but when I have Microsoft, every single transaction is different. So I cannot use this exact one, but I can do contains. And so what I want to do here is I'm going to put Microsoft in there. But what if I go to the Microsoft store and I buy a laptop? Or what if I do an annual renewal when I didn't want to? I might want to have some controls around that. I might not want to go ahead and have all of these Microsoft charges, especially if I want to have them auto add down here. I might want to say only things under a certain amount should be categorized to software. So I'm going to actually set a software limit because let's say I do want to go buy laptops occasionally and I might go to a Microsoft store. If that transaction comes in, Microsoft would probably show up at some point in time in the bank text, but I don't want that to be categorized to software. So we're going to go amount is less than $50 because I know my Microsoft bills are always under $50, okay? So if this is, again, and this is all both of these rules in tandem, so bank text contains Microsoft and then amount is less than $50, then it's going to assign an expense. And let's see if they have a software category here. They don't. Do they have any computer charges? That's the problem with using somebody else's QuickBooks. Is they don't have your categories the same way. So let's add a software expense while we're at it. Let's go to expenses. And okay, so now I have a software category, and then I always want this to be okay, so it will always show up as Microsoft. It'll always show up as software. And for this one, I'm actually going to turn on auto add so that we can, because I know that anything under $50 is going to be software related. Okay. Let's go ahead and save that one. Okay. So now I've got these three rules. Let's go ahead and add another one that might, let's add another one. Let's add Starbucks. So Starbucks is another place that you might have multiple different categories. Things might be, you might go out and meet a client for coffee, or you might buy gift cards for your employees to say thank you for, let's say, administrative assistant appreciation day or something like that. So if that's the case, you might have those in different categories. You should. So let's say this is money out. And we're going to go, again, I'm going to use the bank text because I think that gives me the most detail. And we're going to go contain Starbucks. And you would look at the actual transaction because it could be that maybe the Starbucks bank text shows something slightly different. Like it might say S bucks or something like that. So you would match this to what the bank text actually shows. And then let's say if description, let's see, let's say if the amount is less than $15, it's probably going to be a coffee with a client. It's probably not going to be much more than $15 for two coffees and maybe a breakfast sandwich or something. So let's go ahead and put that in there. And then when we get gift cards for our employees, we typically do $25 and above, let's just say, or it's typically $25. So if that's the case, then we would say, hey, let's try to filter this out. Usually things under $15 are probably meals instead of anything else. Now, it could also be travel meals, so you could go ahead and set this as default, but this kind of depends on your business. Maybe you only have Starbucks expenses when you're traveling, and if that was the case, you would change this to travel meals, okay? And then you would always put in the payee, good best practice, save the Starbucks. And then in this situation, I would recommend definitely turning off auto add because Starbucks could be lots of different things, but this will save you time. Maybe, you know, 75% of the transactions go by this rule, and maybe, you know, those other 25%, you can see the rule and you can still change the category, okay? So even though the rule is there, it doesn't mean that you can't break the rule and change the transaction. All right, and then the last one that I'm going to walk you guys through is something called, I'm gonna do an email marketing. So I use ConvertKit for my email marketing, so we're gonna set this up. Money out, all bank accounts. We're also going to do bank text, and then we're going to do contains ConvertKit. And in this situation, maybe we put this to, you know, we have software now. I'm going to go ahead and put this to software, and then I'm going to create that payee. So in this situation, I believe that I would just want this to go to software expense every single month, and I don't necessarily feel the need to review this. I would be reviewing in my financial review, so if ConvertKit started to get too high of a fee, that would be something that we would see in the P&L review every single month. But this would be one of those things that we could always put to software, and it might make sense to go ahead and do an auto add. Now, remember this, whether you want to auto add or not is really up to you and what you think is reasonable and how much you really want to review the transactions as they come through. A lot of people want to have a lot of oversight for every single transaction as it's coming through. And if that's the case and you're not doing a detailed P&L review, then I think this, you know, turn off auto add. Totally fine. Still going to make your bookkeeping a lot faster. All right. I'm going to go ahead and save that one as auto add though. Okay. And that's what this little signature is over here. So if there's this little green sign, then that means it's auto add. And then if there's no sign, then, you know, not a problem. You can always go in and edit any of these transactions and you can turn them off. You can disable them or delete them entirely. And then you can also reorder these because this shows the priority. So you might want to change the priority of first this before that, okay? And you can just do that really simply by dragging these things.
Okay, bank rules. I'm glad you guys have learned everything you need to know about setting up bank rules. So go ahead and start. Go ahead and try a couple, see how it's working for you, see if the system is recognizing things as it should. And as you set those up, you're gonna start to think, ooh, that could be a rule, that could be a rule, that could be a rule. And then before you know it, you're gonna make your monthly bookkeeping super easy peasy, okay? So I hope all of this information has been able to help you and hopefully save you time in the future. And we will talk to you soon. All right. Remember to subscribe if you're not already. Okay. All right. Bye, everybody.